So now in 2002, Israel Jordan announced the project, the Palestinian weren't on board. And in 2003, the World Bank took the initiative to start talking to the Palestinian about the three riparian parties in the lower Jordan River. We went through difficult negotiation until the Palestinian became represented equally as well as the Israeli and the Jordanian. Now there is a steering committee. We're here for representing the Palestinian at the steering committee. Israel is represented by four, Jordan is represented by four, and the World Bank is represented by two members in that steering committee. What's good in the TUR, and we are always talking about, I'm not talking just in specific because I don't see, I see you all specialized in water stuff and in the study. The decision at the steering committee is taken by consensus. So if I want something with Jordan and Israel doesn't want it, will not go forward. The same is applicable. If Jordan and Israel agree for something and we don't want, it will not go forward. And this is what's good. And this is why we say this is a feasibility study. This is good. It's looking to one option. It's true. It's looking to one option, like the canal. And to address the crisis happen, we will not actually wait until to resolve the other 300 conflict issues in the region. Even 300, I'm really modest. There's many problems in this region. So what's the idea? I don't know if now I'm intervening in Steve Littner presentation, because they had the public stakeholder meeting in Amman. You came today or you came yesterday?
Yesterday.
So we didn't have time actually to coordinate the presentation. But the idea is just to transfer around 2 billion cubic meter. 1 billion will go to the Dead Sea and 1 billion will be desalinated. The Dead Sea is unique on the Earth. This is the lowest point on Earth, the Dead Sea. We're thinking of pumping the water around 100 meter, 120 meter, then dropping the water for minus 400. So using this difference of elevation, 500 meter, will produce energy. Part of that energy will be used for desalination and for pumping of water. Now, think there is a problem, there is a crisis in terms of water here in Palestine because of the conflict of water between us and the Israeli. But there is a deficit, there is a huge deficit at the Palestinian side. There is a deficit in Jordan and in Israel. But talking about this project, you think about it in 15 years' time. Now we're talking about feasibility study will take 2 years, and then if it's feasible and the party goes ahead, the party go ahead with this, some people say 6 up to 10 years. So so think about the water situation and the energy in 15 years time. So this is one of the benefit as we see it. And I'm talking on behalf of the Palestinian Authority, I'm not on behalf of myself. There is job creation, benefit, tourism, many things that maybe Steve will talk about. Again, to the political, the project has been criticized that it might undermine the Palestinian right. We said, okay, the caveat didn't save us legally. We weren't able to agree on the management of the Jordan River Basin. That you are there is that each party can have a water statement, so we can say what we want to say and leave the political discussion to not be in this context. So we actually the Palestinian keep looking to the right issue in the TUR. The Jordanian want this project at any price because they want the water, the energy, and they want to save the sea. And the Israeli, they are engaged in the feasibility study. And for them, as an Israeli, they might think about such project as a project for normalization. So all these, this is where each party stand. Finally, we don't believe that this project has an impact on the water right, because people say that Israel is pushing for desalination. Well, if the water right conflict remains another 15 years, well, it's a disaster. And we're thinking now of creating a Palestinian state. Now, people talking about 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, and you hear, I don't want to engage in a politics, but water remain one of the permanent status issue that should be resolved based on the international law and mainly the equitable utilization principle. We agree that desalination will be some part in the equation of the water issue to be resolved. And just, it will play an important tool in order to solve that. The alternative, Steve Letter will talk about, and finally now, Persian Water Authority, Energy Authority, Environmental Authority, and the negotiation support unit are actually representing Palestine and Palestinian people in the steering committee. There is a thinking now to establish the committee of experts, and this is one of the recommendations of Dr. Awad Tabi's workshop, that there is a need to establish a Palestinian expert committee to assist and support the people who sit at the steering committee. Please, this is just, I gave the steering committee presentation to you, so you are, we're hiding nothing on this. We are transparent. We need to hear from you in order to improve our performance working in the steering committee. Here I stop and I give the floor to Mr. Lettner, and thank you.